The Wars of the Roses is really, it's a 15th century version of the Mafia story. It's powerful families turning on each other in pursuit of who will rule the country, who wear the crown. You have two great houses, York and Lancaster. The Red Rose of Lancaster, the White Rose of York. Both are led by charismatic leaders. There's a series of battles. They are furious, violent, and quite savage. No prisoners are taken. And Lancaster emerges as the victor after a very, very long struggle. Well, what I do is, most of the novels are the product of an imagination. So you can imagine a story sitting on a train, or waiting for a bus, or simply just sitting on a garden bench. Ideas come to you, and you weave them, and you develop the story accordingly. It's sometimes you get a real flush of inspiration. But it's not difficult. I don't find it difficult. I find it very, very enjoyable.